This cheap Amazon hairpiece can't be an amazing 1960s hairstyle.
Or can it? Mass available hairpieces have gotten a little boring. That's not the right word. Basic. They've gotten a little basic. Which is fine for hair extensions when you just want to make your hair a little longer. Those should be simple. I think it's time for some more interesting options.
Something more exciting than just a ponytail holder wrapped in curly synthetic hair.
So how about we turn one of these basic hair pieces into something a little bit more inspired? Something like a 1960s chic updo, because that's what we do here. Hi, if you didn't know that that's what we do here, I'm Lauren. I am a hairstylist, blogger, teacher, and obsessor over vintage beauty, mostly vintage hair.
So today, let's get into hair pieces in the context of vintage hairstyles, specifically 1960s hairstyles.
And what could be more flattering than a style which can be adapted simply by the addition of a matching wiglet? When hairstyling is in such expert hands, then there's no limit to ingenuity. Take a tip from nature, and with this elegant cocktail creation, Joanne's personality...
The 1960s knew a little something about great hair pieces. Especially in the mid-1960s, women's hairstyles got bigger, and these ladies needed a little extra faux support to stay in fashion. Many hair pieces were made of human hair, but thanks to scientific advances in synthetic materials production during World War II, women in the 1960s could also get cheaper hair pieces made of mode acrylic fibers. In 1949, the chemical company Union Carbide had started commercially producing mode acrylic, the magical synthetic that a lot of our faux hair pieces are still made of today. Mode acrylic is soft, resilient, can be easily dyed, shows good shape retention, and dries quickly, so it's great for using as fake hair. In the 1960s, the most common hair pieces women used were switches, wiglets, falls, and wigs. Switches are a long length of a group of hair strands that can be braided and twisted into bun and chignon shapes.
Simple dress, Madonna-like hairdo. Madonna-like hairdo, oh, that's it, a switch, a switch.
You got one?
Dozens.
Mame, don't you ever throw anything away.
Who knows when I may go back to one of these colors. Well, darling, here, hold the switch so I can braid it till it looks like a halo.
Wiglets, like the piece we are working with today, are a topper piece for the crown of the head that usually came pre-curled or styled. The interior had a base with a hair comb attached to quickly attach your hairpiece and go. Falls were kind of like the half wigs of today. They are designed to sit an inch or two back from the front hairline and blend in. Here is the character Megan Draper in the show Mad Men wearing a fall. The show's hairstylist often put her character in hairpieces, which perfectly illustrates how a modern stylish woman in the mid-1960s would use hairpieces to make dramatic hairstyles, but then have a daily manageable hairstyle. Falls came in many lengths, whether a woman wanted to wear a longer style or a cute bob that was such a popular haircut at the time. Wigs, of course, are a full coverage hairpiece for when you want to slip on your second head.
So let's get right to it. I actually bought several of these because I wasn't sure which one I was going to work with for this video, and it's starting to look like I have a bunch of bleach blonde triples.
Aye, they're into the machinery, all right.
I'll put links to all of these in the description. I know I need a hairpiece with quite a bit of strands to do the look I have in mind. Some of these smaller ones with hair wrapped around an elastic just weren't quite right. This claw clip ponytail hairpiece won't be quite right for what I want, but there is this awesome trick with these. If you turn it upside down, the hair condenses and splays out to look more like a 1960s poof. I'm gonna have a ton of fun with this one at Viva this year. I settled on working with this synthetic hairpiece I got for $15 on Amazon. Like the wiglet of the 1960s, it has hair combs for attaching to your own hair. It also has elastic on either side to give you a little control over size. The hair is a bunch of wefts stitched incrementally together. In the online listing, they demonstrate placement with the combs on either side of the head, but that isn't going to give me the silhouette I want in the hairstyle. So I turn it to place one comb at the apex top of my head and one at the center back. This is closer to what I want. I'll style the curls to cover the comb, but you could also decorate the comb edge with flowers or something to cover it. The supplies I am using to get the hairpiece to a sensational 1960s updo are T-pins to secure the piece during styling, a rat tail comb, teasing comb with pick, hair clips for separating, bobby pins, hairspray, some more loose motacrylic hair, and a hairnet. I'm styling this on a styrofoam head. You can also just pin the piece to the edge of your fabric couch or corner of a mattress to stabilize it. I wouldn't suggest trying to style this while it's on your head. You could bobby pin something to your own hair, which would make easily removing the piece undisturbed for future use difficult. I am situating it similarly to how I want to wear it, so I can have better control over the silhouette. I want the volume at the top and the back style to be closer to the scalp. Styling is broken up into three main steps: sectioning, build structure, style the curls. As a guide for sectioning, I'm using the weft pattern of the hairpiece. There is a weft at either end at the base of the attached hair combs. Along the interior, there are eight main wefts. Three wefts on each side and two down the center. Section the hairpiece using these wefts as your guide. First, I separate the wefts at the top and bottom at the combs. Then I part the hair to find the interior wefts. Clip these pieces together to the left, center, and right to keep them together. Three wefts to the left, two wefts down the center. Three wefts to the right. Continue down until everything is clipped in place. You'll have five main sections. The center section is going to be the main base of the structure of the hairpiece. I take 1/3 of it at the top and back comb with the teasing comb while directing the hair to the left. I take the next 1/3 and back comb it, directing it to the right. And then the last 1/3 at the bottom gets teased to the left again. Next, I build a base for the hairstyle using hair padding or a hair wrap. You can use loose acrylic hair and a hairnet to build the padding. I am using the Bouffant Shape and Style Hair Padding Kit from VintageHairstyling.com. Teasing the strands into a ratty ball. Wrap the hairnet around it and shape it. Remember that whatever shape you make the padding will be the shape of the hair on top. I want bulk at the top, but not at the bottom. So I shape the rat into sort of a whale shape. Place the padding down the center of the section you just teased with the wider end at the top and bobby pin it to the wefts underneath. I start at the bottom back. Why? I want the volume at the top. If I start at the front and work my way back, I will be more likely to end up with even volume all around. If I start at the lower back and form the hair up as I build, I will be more likely to end up with the hair focused upward, giving me more hair and hence more volume on the upper end. The great thing about this synthetic hairpiece is the hair is already curly and it holds the curl really well. So I can start smoothing out those teased sections in the center and direct them over the hair padding into curls and waves. Then bobby pins can anchor the curls into the padding. Continue with the middle section until you have covered the hair padding. Moving to the left section, I will again be working in thirds, but they aren't even pieces. I increase the amount of hair in each curl piece as I work up so that there is more volume at the top. You do have to do trial and error with these curls. The hair is going to do what it feels like doing, so just play with the placement until it looks good to you. The 1960s hairstyle was all about smooth mounds, whether they were beehives or poofs. So I am trying to make the majority of this style more like small, smooth mounds. Moving to the right section, I will again be working in thirds, increasing the amount of hair in each curl piece as I work up so that there is more volume at the top. I'm leaving the front and back hair sections as is for now. I will incorporate these pieces with my own hair when I style it.
So let's get to styling this actually on my head. This is my hair length. I've recently got a lot of it chopped off. My plan to have a little bit of a bang thing happening, like a little thing. And then I want to curl these front pieces right here up a little bit so I can incorporate them into the front of the hairpiece. I'm realizing now I think I toned my hair a little too dark to go with this hairpiece, but it'll wash out in a week and it'll match better. Then I'm gonna take, I want to do, because I really like this cute, like, curly thing. So I want to try that on one side and then the other side. I think I'm just gonna pin it back. When you see a lot of the pictures of women in the 60s with these hair pieces on, they have all their hair up. Well, I don't really have enough hair. I'll just do it back on one side, and then this will probably be back a little bit. And then back here, since it's just definitely too short to pin up, I will just leave this out and style it. I'm just gonna do this with a curling iron today. I don't have time to really sit and wet set.
I'm only worried about curling the front section of my hair, so I sectioned the front out. I always prep hair with a thermal setting spray before iron curling. With a 1-inch curling iron, I curled the top curls that I will incorporate with the strands of the hairpiece and pin them to cool. For the bangs, I directed the hair forward to curl since I don't want a lot of volume in the bangs. For the side curl, I used a 3/4-inch curling iron to get a little more curl and pinned the curls to cool.
On to the back. How do you do your hair from the back when you can't see it? I have this handy mirror that I got on the interwebs. I will leave a link down in the description. This thing is a lifesaver. I take this with me to Viva. You can bend it and shape it to see the back of your hair.
Since the back will all just be under the hairpiece, I pin the loose hair back.
Now I'm nervous. I'm gonna take these curls and just get them kind of out of the way.
I tease the top so that the hair comb won't slip back when I place it.
I'm gonna put the comb, hopefully you can see that's right there. Let's see.
Now I take those loose back pieces and back comb, shape them, and pin them to cover the hair comb and any obvious holes in the hairstyle in the back. For the side curl, I comb through and mold the curl with some pomade to shape it.
So I'm just going to take these pieces and the front pieces, incorporate them, cover some of these because I don't want that comb to show. I don't want it prommy up here. I want nice big round curls like the 60s curls.
At the front, I just play with the placement of the curls to keep that exterior barrel shape and make sure that they look good together.
I'm gonna take this last piece, cover up that hole, and style out the bangs. I love the way this turned out. Can you believe this thing was $15? I just got an amazing hairstyle for $15. I don't know what to say. It's adorable. It is adorable. This piece right here that I was like curly, I decided that it was just looking too forced. Wasn't looking like the easy look of the 60s at all. So I actually sprayed it down with a little bit of water to loosen it up. Used my curling iron to smooth it into just more of a swoop instead of a curl. So just to recap, the reason this hairstyle looks more 1960s, less 2003 prom, I keep saying 60s. I've said before, and you should go back and look at my video about what decade is your hairstyle, that like a hairstyle that was popular in 1961 and a hairstyle that was popular in 1966, completely different looking. So this is actually more mid 65, 66. This is when this look started getting really in vogue. Is the curls are big, like they're the chunky rolls of curls. It's more about seeing the exterior of the curls and not a bunch of little tunnels. Part of the reason that those hairstyles looked so specific in the 1960s, the way that they brought emphasis to the curve of the outside of the roll, not emphasis to the interior of the curl. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. It should be down there, right? So down there is the subscribe button. You can also go to my website, vintagehairstyling.com, and pick up hair tools for doing vintage hairstyles, and also read more about mid-century beauty history on the bobby pin blog. Thanks for watching. I don't want to take it off.